His Excellency Dr. Sultan bin Ahmad Sultan Al Jaban, Minister of Industry and Advanced Technology, UAE. His Excellency Mr. Angus Taylor, Minister of Energy and Emission Reduction, Australia. His Excellency Dan Jorgensen, Minister of Climate and Energy Utilities, Denmark. His Excellency Mr. David M. Tull, Deputy Secretary of Energy, United States. Friends from the media, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to welcome the Ministerial College distinguished panelists representing the entire value chain of the hydrogen economy, representatives from the industry, academia and think tanks to the inaugural edition of the Hydrogen Roundtable titled Hydrogen Economy, New Delhi Dialogue 2021. I thank the Energy Forum and PP for holding this unique roundtable on hydrogen at a time when global efforts are focused on finding ways to develop a hydrogen economy, both at the national level as well as at a global scale. I am pleased to see the overwhelming response from the global community for this roundtable, which seeks to deliberate and explore several important aspects of hydrogen ecosystem to build environmental sustainability and enhance energy security. Excellencies and friends, the contours of India's energy transition are changing fast. Honorable Prime Minister of India, Sri Narendra Modi, has outlined a new energy map of India in October last year with 7 key drivers. And indeed, one of them is development of emerging fuels, particularly hydrogen. Needless to say, energy is integral to support our fast-growing economy. We are developing an energy sector which will be growth-centric, industry-friendly, and environment-conscious. We have the onerous task of ensuring energy justice and to end energy poverty in the country. This requires ample access to affordable energy to improve the lives of Indians, coupled with the need to have a smaller carbon footprint. Our government is developing a clear roadmap for a self-reliant India or an Atmanirbhar Bharat, which seeks to place India as a manufacturing hub well integrated with global supply chains. In this report, energy will have a defining role. Excellencies, friends, surely hydrogen has great potential to emerge as a future source of energy. The enthusiasm about hydrogen has a simple reason. Whether it's used in fuel cell or burned to create heat, whether hydrogen replaces fossil fuel, it shows global warming. Inclusion of hydrogen as an energy carrier in the future energy portfolio presents a unique opportunity to address emerging energy vectors, including power to gas, power to power, and power to mobility, and even vehicle to grid applications. India remains committed to environmental and climate cause with a massive thrust on deploying renewable energy and energy efficiency measures. In the past 6 years, India has increased its renewable power portfolio from 32 gigawatt to almost 100 gigawatt. We are well on track to achieve 450 gigawatt target of renewable energy generating capacity by 2030. Diversification of our energy basket will be the key lever enabling this transition. However, it is equally important that the new energy mix options synergize and coexist with the established base technology already operational in the respective countries in which huge capital investments have been made. That's why the emergence of hydrogen at the center stage is a welcome development. Excellencies, friends, in India, we have taken various initiatives with respect to the greater use of hydrogen in India's energy mix. Government of India recently announced the National Hydrogen Mission in Union Budget 2021 for making a hydrogen roadmap for the country. We're working on the pilot project on blue hydrogen, hydrogen CNG, and green hydrogen. Through technological advancement, we are blending hydrogen with compressed natural gas, CNG, for use as transportation fuel as well as an industrial input to refineries. 50 buses in Delhi are playing on blended hydrogen in compressed natural gas on a pilot basis. We plan to scale it up in the coming months across the major cities of India. My Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas, with mandate of keeping the energy pipeline flowing, is committed to augment the hydrogen supply chain infrastructure in the country. Presently, as in the case of other countries, our petroleum sector is the largest producer of hydrogen for various refinery process operations. Hence, we realize petroleum sector's capability to produce hydrogen molecules stored and traded as a gas, making it a natural votary of this new energy form. It provides us an opportunity to utilize existing business models and infrastructure unlike other e-options. Hydrogen is also capable of aligning with my ministry's other flagship schemes, like the promotion of compressed biogas under the Sustainable Alternative for Affordable Towards Transportation Satat scheme, or promoting the gas-based economy or other initiative on waste to energy. Such an integration will impact much more flexibility and capacity utilization to the vast infrastructure available or being created in India. Excellencies and friends, the utility of hydrogen is not going to be limited only to the transport sector. The maturity of the ecosystem can be accelerated through its uses as a decarbonizing agent for a range of sectors, including industry covering chemicals, iron, steel, fertilizer and refining, transport, heat and power. Role of hydrogen as a chemical is well known. We all now recognize the importance of hydrogen as an energy carrier, and efforts are underway to devise ways to harness it in a reliable, cost-effective and safe manner. By establishing synergies with natural gas, hydrogen can be easily adopted in the energy mix without seeking major infrastructural overhauling. We are looking forward to introduce HCNG as an intermittent technology in a big way for both automotive and domestic cooking applications. India is looking towards various colors to kickstart the hydrogen ecosystem development. Our refineries are planning to leverage the available surplus hydrogen capacities in grey form for meeting the initial demand in the mainstreaming hydrogen. One of such projects is underway at our Gujarat refinery of Indian Oil, wherein the combination of hydrogen production through natural gas and its hyphenation with the carbon capture technology will result in the production of blue hydrogen. Multiple buses powered by fuel cells will be covering various iconic routes. Efforts are underway to leverage the fast CNG pipeline infrastructure to reduce the transportation cost of hydrogen. Excellency and friends, as convergence in global efforts is critical towards building significant share of hydrogen in the energy system, I am confident that this inaugural New Delhi Dialogue 2021 will prepare a sound ground for germinating and nurturing some of the path-breaking developments, both on policy fronts as well as in the implementation aspects, in the time to come. India, with its steadfast efforts towards leading the energy transition, backed by robust political will, is committed to engage with partners for ushering in the hydrogen economy. I look forward to the outcomes of this roundtable and wish you success. I once again thank ministerial colleagues and distinguished panelists for taking their valuable time for participating in this event. Thank you. Namaste.